So that's what we're trying to avoid. And actually, a few years ago, we did come to the city because we had a major, we got hit real hard, real quick with nitrates and MTBE that we were asking people to actually conserve water until we, when we've gotten some new supply online to replace that. But it's going to be an ongoing thing for quite a while.
And what does MTBE stand for?
Methyl terbutyl ether. It was the gasoline additive that they put in fuels.
Oh, right.
And it leached down into the water supply. It cleaned the air up, but kind of ruined the water.
Okay. So. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner. I had just a couple of questions myself, quick for clarification. Thank you. So this new well will replace the long ongoing problem you've had with previous wells over the years. Is this a resolve, or is it have capacity for a future? So if you had three more wells go out next month,
It would certainly help. And don't scare me like that. I hope we don't lose three wells in the next month.
I guess what I'm asking is, if you're trying to solve this problem, and how are you looking towards the future if you have more wells?
We've actually done long-term water supply plan for the city of Salinas through the year 2020, and one of them is an aggressive program to start replacing wells. A lot of the wells here, this system was originally owned by Pacific Gas and Electric, and Cal Water purchased it in 62. So a lot of the infrastructure is really old. The actual life capacity of a well is generally around 50 years. We've had some of them that are running now 70 years that we've had to put, you know, $2 million treatment plants on, and just hoping that the well still stays running, because it's hard to find the land and, you know, the infrastructure to get the water where you need it. I mean, if you look at the city growth in the core of the city, where a lot of the water is used, it's difficult to get water into that area. We were fortunate, like with Oak and Pajaro, that we were able to get a lot there on the corner, so we put a well there.
Now, how many customers do you plan on serving with this?
This will serve what we call our systems divided into pressure gradients, and it's going to serve the 155 zone is what we call it. It's that pressure gradient zone. I'm going to say there's probably 10,000 connections that it will assist, because they're all tied into the same grid. So it's difficult to say an exact number of homes that it will serve, but in that zone we have about 10,000 connections. And that zone basically runs from Rossi Street to kind of 101 south, from Davis to the edge of our system where we border up with Alco.
And then the infrastructure in place right now would need minor modifications, or is adequate to just build the well and attach to the infrastructure?
The pipeline capacity right now is fine. We're not looking at upsizing any of that.
Okay.
That's why we're even looking down with Unicool Partners for that development down there, because we have the pipeline capacity in Abbott Street. So. Okay. Though this isn't supporting that.
Thank you, Mr. Jones. Were there any other questions, Commissioner Mendez? Yeah,
thank you, Ken. I just want to touch up on the mitigation part of this particular application. I want to go to section on the hydrology and water quality, and where it says on the column issue, where it says potential for discharge of storm water to impair the beneficial uses of the receiving waters or areas that provide water quality benefit. According to this packet, it says that it has a potential significance impact unless mitigated factions are incorporated. So I'd like to ask you, what has been mitigated in regards to stormwater issues?
Anyone on the city's M4 permit on that for discharge?
So we applied for NPDES.
Yeah, we applied for the NPDES permit to tie in. We're already tied into the city's stormwater system through the M4 permit, so that's
the, okay.
What's he talking about drilling?
Well, I mean, it says that it has a...
Going
No, I'm talking about runoff discharge to our.
We don't generally, I mean, we discharge into the storm drains.
Well, according to this packet, it's actually a potentially significant, unless I'm totally misinterpreting what I'm reading here.
During construction.
If I okay. might, let me what jump in on this one.
Page is that, sir?
I believe the question is in reference to page 18, 19, and 20 in the initial study, which is attached to the staff report. There is a potential for runoff from the site. However, there's a mitigation measure that requires a stormwater pollution prevention plan, otherwise known as a SWPP, S-W-P-P-P. And this will be required at the time of building permit submittal to make sure that the surface waters are not impacted. It will employ VMPs and BATs, which are best management practices to manage the runoff from the property. Yeah.
Sorry, Courtney, I wasn't quite following you. I was trying to get to that page. Yeah, Courtney, just.
Sure. There's a mitigation measure that's designed to address stormwater impacts of waters leaving the site. It's shown as mitigation measure HW1.
Oh, okay. I see that. Right on. Thanks, Courtney. Appreciate that. Thank you, Mike, for the info. Appreciate it.
No problem. By the way, this is Randy Roden, our project engineer from San Jose.
Nice to meet you.
In case you have any more questions. That one went kind of above my head.
That's all I got, Ken. Thanks.
Thank you, Commissioner. Any other questions or comments while we have gentlemen on the hot seat? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Was there any other public comments you'd like to receive now? Seeing none, we'll close the hearing and I will open it up for commissioners' comments and additional questions. Commissioner Huerta, any questions or comments?
No, just, I mean, it's a longstanding water service provider in Salinas and they're trying to do the right thing and taking on a lot of risk as far as from a business perspective, and we need them to do it. So I wish them luck and I'm supportive of the conditions that we have here that seem to be in order, and a lot of other agencies have already looked at it, elementary school district, the California Department of Public Health, and other folks have had a long time to look at this, so it's very transparent to everybody that what they're trying to do is in the best interests of the community. I'm supportive. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Carrillo.
I will just echo what Commissioner Huerta said, and I agree that they're trying to provide the best water quality for our community, and I'm supportive of what they're doing.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Mendez?
Yeah, this is obviously a project that's extremely needed here in Salinas. You know, they lost, according to the packet, they lost 8 wells, but from what I hear from Mike, they lost obviously more than that. So it's a needed project. My concerns obviously has been answered. You know, the runoff problem, I was kind of big concerned about that one, but Courtney pointed out to me the mitigated column on that. And they are working with other agencies, and the one agency that I'm pretty well familiar with is the Monterey County Water Resource Agency. You know, so that was good to hear. But no, I'm pretty satisfied with this project here. Thanks.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Massey.
No comment. I agree with it and look forward to getting the job done.
Thank you. Commissioner Araujo.
I appreciate that they're willing to take this big financial risk to provide, you know, water, needed water to the community. I don't know where to go with the fact that we have processes in place that I assume are legal. I don't see any big lawsuits going on here that permit contamination of usable water, a finite resource on this planet. I mean, that's huge. And thank goodness they're willing to drill deeper to find fresh water. But I don't know where to go with my concern about where is it in our realm, you know, in our planning process of maintaining the usability of our finite resources. especially something like water. It's not relevant, I mean, to what they're putting forth, but this has come to my attention, so I'm just wanting to put that somewhere for discussion, and I don't know where it would go on our agenda.
Want to answer that, Chris?
We could put it under consideration of the council.
Could we put that under council considerations?
Well,
to explore that question, even if we can't go very far with it today.
I would defer to the.
Well, we don't have any information to answer that question today. At least the staff doesn't. But and Alan can, you know, mm-hmm. correct me if I'm wrong. But if you'd like us to come back with additional information, perhaps we can.
Yeah, I think as far as the regional perspective on water, we really need to defer to the Monterey County Water Resources Agency. And if you want to address that larger issue of long-term water supply for Salinas, that they would be the appropriate agency.
Okay, so for right now, could we talk a little more about this on today's agenda with my question? I would like that. May we do that? And as far as this project goes, I think it's necessary. It's where we are right now, and I'm grateful they're willing to make the investment.
Thank you, Commissioner. Mm-hmm. I have no.
Well, the public hearing is closed, Mr. Carruthers.
Public hearing is closed. Public hearing is closed on this matter.
I guess if
the council wishes, I could reopen.
We could reopen public comment later.
That'd be fine.
General public comment.
General public comment, not for items.
I have a specific answer to her question.
Oh, well, that'll come under another item in the agenda, but thank you for the help. I'm sorry. Public comments closed right now. Thank you. Okay, and so again, I have no further comments to make on this issue. So I guess what I'm looking for would be a motion consider appropriate action.
I'd like to make a motion that we approve this item, Chair.
I would like to second that.
So there's a motion and a second to approve a conditional use permit 2010-008. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Rahm?
Yes.
Yes.
Commissioner Matthews?
Yes.
Commissioner Quirkland?
Yes.
Commissioner
Yes. Yes.
Okay, motion passes unanimously. So conditional use permit 2010-008, a request to construct a new water well at an existing water storage tank site located at 1320 Dayton Street in IG Industrial General District. The Planning Commission has just approved this item. The request for a conditional use permit, which cannot be issued for 10 days. During this 10-day period, any person having standing to do so under the law who is aggrieved by this action or decision may file an appeal with the Community Development Department located at 65 West Allisal Street. Thank you, Commissioners.
Thank you, Vice Chair Sierpinski, for your help in facilitating that. We'll move on to item E3. I've been told that this item has been continued to next commission meeting.
To the next meeting, which is the 17th, Courtney?
November 17.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So that said, we'll move on to item F, and that's commission considerations. Given the discussion about water quality and interest there, we could take that under consideration for a future meeting, perhaps any further discussion. I think that would be the most appropriate action at this time. Seeing no other business, follow-up reports, perhaps there's something that Alan would want to comment on. I know that you'd provided us with the information on the draft Chinatown rebound. Was there something that would be appropriate at this time to say about that?
Yes, I just wanted to bring to the commission's attention and extend an invitation to all of the commissioners to a meeting in Chinatown to this will be the final